Today it's August 30th, 2020. Here are some of my thoughts about this very special, uncommon, disturbing, and unusual year 2020. How to use common sense in trying times? What does it mean to be healthy in the year 2020? The way the medical industry has begun to look at symptoms of flu and fever, any form of response by a healthy immune system to infection, poison or substance causing an allergy, is as if it's not supposed to be present and if it's an enemy, a bad thing that should be avoided or done away with. Hence the general view and methods to fix any condition that is a result of that natural response of our human immune system. The understanding of health has become a materialistic view with expectations of how it should look like and feel. Appearances and performance, these two have become the norm in many aspects of our lives in Western societies since the start of our second millennium. The external world and the virtual world of the Internet of Things are given more attention than what's stirring beneath the inner lining of our bodies and the state of our emotional and mental balance. Know that I'm impressed by the technical development in surgery and physical repair with plates, new knees, hips, and other parts of the physical body. There are doctors and nurses who dedicate their life and love for healing and putting an end to suffering. I'm sure of it. There's much confusion, you know. Plus, an equally important argument from that materialistic point of view that the economy shouldn't be affected by these disturbances, the need to go on sick leave and be away from work for long periods of time. That's not convenient to the machinery of moneymakers and the slave masters who expect often that human beings are automatons, obeying to what's designed by these masters on their blackboards. Since I've retired from working life, the world of labor and the 24-hour economy looks like utter madness to me. All my working years, I've worked a maximum of 3 days a week, for I knew that my health would suffer from a 36 to 40-hour working week. Besides, I need my work as an artist, crafter, and writer. Creativity is the oxygen in my body and the gym for my soul. The biggest mistake that the present medical industry has based its treatments on is the idea that the human immune response is a sign of disease, while in truth it's a sign of health, the ability to respond to an effect with a lively vigor. The higher the fever, the healthier one's immune system is. It's a sign of proper response, and the more we allow our immune system to be alive and kicking by living in a natural way, which to me means life in connection with the soil, the elements, the changing of the weather, a conscious relationship with nature, the animal and plant kingdom, and stewardship in a communal effort to create nurturing conditions within the family and the world at large. Living conditions without the use of disinfectants, antibiotics, chemical substances, killers of bugs, bacteria, and all other crawly critters affecting our system, the stronger we'll keep ourselves alive, feeling healthy and conscious about our health and the choices we make to take care of our physical, emotional, and mental condition. It's my pillar of trust in life that when I say yes to life, life responds with a yes to me. Asking questions, wondering and pondering is your birthright. That's called the use of common sense. Most of our anxiety is a result of going in circles with imaginations and fantasies, easily resulting into fear. Fear for the unknown that doesn't exist. That condition drains your energy, the energy that is made to better use for your daily activities, your joys and sense of fulfillment. What follows is my also my views and recommendations about how to prepare for living conditions when everything changes and is not familiar anymore, like this year, 2020, for many of us. Personally, I doubt if prepping by buying canned food and other long-lasting food products are useful. One needs to know how food is produced and fabricated first before making a choice of what to stock up. Apart from knowing one's motive, coming from fear or from the use of common sense. What is in need to be questioned? Do I live in a safe location with my family? What brings me peace of mind and body and those of my family? What do I need to study, explore and learn, practice in order to create a lifestyle that keeps me alive with my family? How do I reach peace of mind and all of my family? Do I have to be at peace with my mind first before finding clarity of mind? What's the best choice? Navel staring and wait for answers, or start acting and doing things that need to be done in order to achieve? At times the answer emerges from the question when it's about peace of mind. For isn't it true that finding peace of mind is equal? To being at peace with one's mind in the presence of our now. I will read that part again. I was scrolling too fast. At times the answer emerges from the question when it's about peace of mind. For isn't it true that finding peace of mind is equal to being at peace with one's mind in the presence of our now? Many of us live in a linear fashion of mind, and when a plan is made, it's like a path disappearing in the distance with a destiny at the end, with peace of mind at the end next to it. Hence the lack of peace at the start of such an endeavor, for our mind goes fast forward, reaching toward that state of peace, at ease at the end of that path. A choice on itself can be state of peace, a state of peace in itself, a conscious creation with clarity in our present moment. When we reach forward to that destiny with our attention, we risk ignoring the beauty that grows alongside our chosen path, even our travel companions and the wayshowers at crossings with other travelers on it. Those travelers are also wayshowers often, showing a different approach, a different direction. In other words, seeing oneself as whole, complete and capable right now is helpful to focus on our present moment and be joyful about it, in contentment, including others around oneself, sharing the same path, close by or a bit further on distance. Every journey begins with the first step. Make it an enjoyable one, I suggest. To me, the best self-empowering way to achieve one's goal, fulfill one's mission and create a lifestyle that includes the well-being of all creatures and not just one's own, with confidence in tow, is making everything a choice, consciously, no matter how small. And start acting on that choice, with observation in tow, also of one's inner responses and physical signals, without the judgment of failure, doubt, guilt or shame ruling one's choice. Observe nevertheless at times. They can remain passers-by, disappearing again in the distance. When daily life in its practicalities, such as finding out how to survive and be safe, shows a need for change, a need for a new choice, then one makes a new choice in the same fashion, etc., etc. By doing this consciously, one witnesses motive, manner and style of achieving within oneself and in others. That's highly educational. See what I mean? Even more, when this ability is shared with one's family members and or one's community members, life begins to be so much more interesting and rewarding. Communication rises to a whole new level in openness, non-violent. Of course, it's a learning curve and a work in progress, always. No linear fashion is helpful in this realm, which brings me on the subject of time. In the Western world, we're living in linear time with the flat surface of the clock in a circle of 12 numbers. In the ancient world, we were living in cyclical time with the number 13 pulling off the circle of 12 from the clock surface into a spiral. The classic Mayan priests observed the skies, were capable of observing planet Earth from a distance. They observed the completion of 13 full moons in a year of 364 days. Each moon lasting 28 days, 13 13 times 28 is 364 days. In other parts of our planet, this was known as well, like in the Shinto religion of old Japan. Today, July 25th, is the day out of time, according to the 13 moon calendar of the classic Maya astronomers. Today, it's Kin 118, white magnetic mirror, reflecting, confrontational, cutting the crap. Magnetic means number one, leading a 13-day wave spell. I'm a yellow cosmic star, Kin 208, the 13th in a wave spell. Today, July 26, 2020, is New Year's Day on this calendar with the blue lunar storm, Kin 119, the year-bearer until July 24, 2021. The energy of the blue lunar storm is polarizing by nature. The action needed is stabilizing, and the purpose is challenge. Blue storm is one's conscious self, who you are and who you are becoming. Red moon represents your challenge and gift. With maturity and awareness, this challenge will turn into a focus. This is what you desire to learn in this lifetime. The yellow star is accompanying the blue storm. It is the complementary factor, something that comes natural to oneself. The white wind, the world of spirit below the blue storm, is the subconscious self and hidden helper. For more study of the 13 moon calendar, I suggest you visit Law of Time website, the work of José Arguelles and Lloydine Arguelles. There are several teachers that have left work and insights about the natural calendar of the Mayans. Challenge doesn't have to be experienced in soaring blood pressure and heart palpitations. Challenge of the blue storm this year until next year, 24th of July. Unless our physical safety is at stake, of course, making everything into a choice releases one from insecurity and confusion, which are energy-draining emotions. It requires stepping out of duality consciousness and release polarizing tendencies. Every choice is a piece of mosaic in the pattern of one's plan. Be it in survival mode or in times of peace, the latter may emerge from the former, unless our physical safety is at stake. And after all, ask yourself, while reading this, how much comfort you are enjoying right now. Our external conditions and circumstances are no rulers over us, unless we make that a choice, consciously. Wouldn't we immediately feel that this choice leads to a confused state and bewilderment? When we are observant, when we are not practicing observation of our instinctual responses, wouldn't that cause damage to our autonomy? Therefore, we need to be truthful to ourselves and clear about our motives and drives. Laughing now, I confess that I remind myself often of what I've shared with you here. Thank you for listening.